am a BTech undergraduate, finally a BTech undergraduate with specialization in computer science and engineering from Veer Surendra Sai University of Technology, Sambalpur, Odisha. I am a member of the Robotics Society and Enigma Club, which is a coding club of VSSUT as well. I am currently an intern at Amazon and will soon be joining Google as the software engineer in July, in the month of July, which is next month. My main interests, technical interests, include robotics and coding, as the clubs I'm in definitely specify. Thank you.
Okay, that was pretty impressive. Robotics, as in like robots banaya, that they move.
बिल्कुल बनाया है line following से start करके.
बनाया हाँ line following because वो NSIT में होता था line following black line.
बिल्कुल 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 black white सब follow किए हैं.
Amazing. Okay. My next question to you, Vartika, is that let's talk about your interview rounds, Google K. Please describe the interview rounds. Go over with us.
Sure. Then after submitting or applying for that position, we received in a week or so a link for a coding round, and we participated in the coding round. Coding round basically consisted of two coding questions, which ranged from medium level to high level. I remember some of them were from graph and some of those kind of topics. And it was like a medium level, so it's okay if you just solve one question as well. That should not be a problem because the level of questions was good. The level mostly matched with the level of questions that come in Kickstart. That is another competition that is hosted by Google on a monthly basis. So if you want, you can search for it on Google or somewhere. So it was of that level. After the coding round, nearly a month later, I received a call from one of the recruiters from Google. And she informed me that I have been selected for the interview. So I probably believe that coding plus the CV must have played the role. I do not really know what happened in the background though. So following that, I mainly had seven rounds of interview. Six were technical rounds and one was leadership and googliness. Now, seven rounds actually sound very dangerous, but it happens in a long span of... but it happened in a span of time. So it's not like all the seven rounds will happen in 1 week or so. It took some months to complete the entire process. So I'll explain. So technical rounds were of similar nature, all six technical rounds. So I'll just explain how each round takes place. In each round, it is nearly 45 minutes. And we are given one or two coding questions. You have to be very strict about the time because it depends on the interviewer, whether the interviewer will actually accept a time beyond 45 minutes or not, if you are like failing to give the answer or something of that kind. So you cannot actually assume that the interviewer will definitely give you 45 minutes. So keep that in mind. Okay. Yeah. Right. So some interviewers ask just one question. And some interviewers ask one question. And if you're able to solve it within the time, they either give you a follow-up question. A follow-up question is a higher version of the previous question, you can say, or an add-on, or a completely different question. Okay, so it ranges from one to two questions. How the process is done is basically they give you the question, they describe you the problem. You share a screen with them. I'll not say sharing a screen, basically a document with the with the interviewer. And whatever they type on that document, you're able to see, and the other way around. So next what happens is we discuss the problem, like you think of solutions and you have to think of the solutions aloud. Now, why is that important is because if the interviewer is sitting idle and then you are sitting idle and thinking on your own, then interviewer will never be able to judge how you do or what you're thinking. So think aloud. Even if you're thinking the wrong thing, think aloud. Talk to the interviewer, tell that, okay, I'm thinking of this, and start with a very basic solution with the highest time complexity. It can be a polynomial time complexity or anything. And then try to reduce the time complexity, space complexity, or solution. So think out aloud. And if you think out aloud, the thing is the interviewer might be able to help you as well. So they do give hints if required. So one thing is that. So be interactive with the interviewer. Once you have come up with a solution and the interviewer agrees with you on that, then the interviewer will ask you to type the answer. So whatever screen you are sharing, you will whatever document you are sharing, you will type the answer there. The interviewer will go through the answers as you type it. And when you type also, keep on describing the whatever you are typing, whatever code you are writing, keep on describing that as well. After that is done, then the interviewer will cross question you a few more questions related to that code only, and then that's it. So if that person wants to ask, like the interviewer wants to ask you another question, it will follow up. Or at the end, they just ask one more question that if you have any questions for us, and you can ask any random question you want, or you can search in Google what you want to ask. And that's it for technical interview.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll go to the Googliness and leadership interview as well. So it is just one normal HR interview where they give you a situation. They ask you how will you react to that situation, or if you have already faced that situation, what was your, the good part about these interviews is the resources are available everywhere. So you can go to YouTube and directly type the Googliness and leadership questions or interview experiences. There are different channels there. You can go to Google. There are different blogs there, and different, like everyone has uploaded their interview experiences. And also, everything is available. Resources are abundant in nature, so that should
share your strategy to prepare for each of the interviews.
Once the lockdown started, you can say my serious preparation started for the interviews. So there are basically two type of companies, as we know. One is service based and product based. So the requirement for both the companies is a little different. For service-based companies, we usually go for aptitude and the general CS subjects. But for product-based, they mainly focus on the data structures and algorithms. So okay. I actually try to do both because early in May, I came to know that like Amazon also has an opening for internship and all. So I wanted to try there as well. But our company, like other companies, service-based companies have also started to come. So I was preparing for both. I'll mainly focus on how I prepared for product-based company, like mainly Google. So I started mainly with the competitive coding on a platform, LeetCode. And I studied my theory part and the concepts from Geeks for Geeks mostly. So they have a list of this, like for every topic you want to cover, like for linked list or for graphs or whatever type of different topics are there, they have this concept. What I did is I picked up one topic at a time. I went through some YouTube videos for it. I went through all the questions as well as solutions. So I did not blindly go to a platform and started solving the questions, because if I do not know the concept behind them, then it is of no use. Like I will not be able to solve the higher level questions. So first of all, I cleared my concepts through the YouTube videos as well as the like internet resources that I had, like Geeks for Geeks or any other resource. Mostly I followed Geeks for Geeks.
Okay.
And I would recommend that as well because it has the section-wise the section-wise documents for each kind of topic. Once I did that, then I went for coding and I practiced regularly. So it took me nearly an year. Like I started from March last year and now it's almost a year. And my result came in March this year, Google's result. So it was like a 1 year. So one thing that will help is learn a skill and do a very small project. That's also okay if you do a very small project. Do a very small project on it and add that into your CV. So it doesn't mean that you have to make a very big deep learning model with like parallel processors and everything. That is not needed. What is needed is whatever skills you know, you should be able to know it. You should completely be able to know it. It's not like you just know everything a very little. That should not be the case. So that's how projects you can do. Like learn a skill, do a small project in it to know that, yeah, I learned this skill, I know this thing. Funny thing, I used to apply in so many companies that I don't even remember the name. I would just wake up one day and I would receive a call and they would say that we are talking from this company and now are you okay to appear in an interview? And that call was my alarm. So I just woke up, I gave an interview as soon as I woke up and then that's it.